from Down Under. Ladies, it's good to see you. This movie is so much fun. But I've got to ask, how did you convince movie bosses to send you on a wild girls trip to Italy?
It was Candice's idea if we were going to do a sequel, to do it in Italy. And so we're eternally grateful to her.
All that wine and beautiful scenery. Gee, that's a tough gig, huh?
It was horrible.
It's awful. Terrible. The pasta.
I love this city.
I love anything that's falling apart more than I am.
The Italian setting sees a lot of sexy behaviour in the film. Was anything off limits?
Well, yeah. I mean, you don't want to go into...
You remember when the handsome policeman shows up?
Buonasera, signora.
And I think he's a male stripper.
Wait a minute. A buff cop just happens to drive by.
Okay. I tried to put my hands down his pants and they wouldn't let me do that, so that was off limits.
I was literally pulling her off of him. No.
How do you rate Italian men?
How would we rate Italian men?
Yes, right.
You would get drunk and then write Italian men.
No, how would you rate them?
Like, rate them?
Yes.
I'm sorry, I'm deaf.
It's not your
fault. Rate them. A plus. Yes, and speaking of, I would rate them A plus. Over the short haul. Over the short haul, not for the long term. But if you believe in monogamy, they know how to seduce you. They know how to make you, especially if you're like 16 years old, they know how to make you feel you're the only woman in the whole world and the most beautiful thing in the whole world. And they're very often gorgeous.
And then they're gone.
And then they're gone, exactly.
Where are you?
I'm in a church.
What? Are you serious?
I'm shocked you didn't burst into flames as you crossed the threshold.
Jane, this time round, there are wedding bells for your character, Vivian. Would you ever walk down the aisle again?
No. Shop is closed up. It's closed up due to flooding.
There's
a sign.
Don't move. What are you doing?
That would be me.
Candice, in this film, you find yourself on the wrong side of the law. Has it ever happened to you in real life?
Well.
Oh, good.
Only once. I went to Washington, D.C. with a group of others to protest the war, and we were arrested.
She has quite a checkered history, I just want you to know.
She's not Little Miss Innocent. You
think it's me, but it's her.
Yeah. She tried to burn a restaurant down when she was 14. She's...
This is a bachelorette party, so okay. You know what that means.
It means that we go see naked men. What's the protocol here? Where do I stuff the dollar bills?
How important is it for you to be acting and representing older women on screen?
It's important.
We have daughters. And I don't want this for my daughter. I don't want it for my three granddaughters. I don't want them to feel like they can't look forward to every single decade and every single moment of their life. And I don't want them to feel like there's a shelf limit, you know, on their dreams. And it's stupid. We have so much to offer. We have fun. We belong up there like everybody else. And so we're enjoying making that little dent in society.
Well, ladies, three icons, this has been such a hoot. Thank you so much for your time.
Thank you for talking to us.
Thank you.
Pinch me, sitting down with those women, three icons of the screen, amazing. And they were just so much fun, as you could tell. They'd been to lunch just before the interview as well, and they were ready to have some fun. I mean, they're ages 76, 70 and 85, Jane Fonda is.
Jane Fonda's 85.
She's 85.
She's a loose unit.
Yeah. She's so much fun. They're all like, so much fun.
I feel like they were all evidence that you get to a certain age where you can say whatever you want.
She
and
said
no
that,
one's
actually.
Yeah.
That's so true. If you're at retirement age, you're like, cancel me. I don't care. Like, I'm already here. What are you going to do?
Exactly.
You be careful is what you do.
Okay,
the
fair enough.
Book club, the next chapter, is in cinemas on Thursday. Check it out.